homemade soap is just wonderful. It's so much fun. It's just a great, great thing to get into. Do you love the Florida Gators? Do you want to make a gift for the gator lovers in your life? I'm going to show you how to make this coconut oil sports team soap for the Gators. It's easier than you think. Let's go.
I'm Becky. I used to live in the consumer rat race just like you. But one day, I had enough, so I sold it all, moved to the country, and built my own log cabin with my own two hands. Now, I spend my time discovering new ways to live a simple, healthy lifestyle with more free time and way less stress, then sharing what I've learned with you. Welcome to Becky's Homestead.
Let me tell you about the qualities of coconut oil and why we chose it for our sports team soap. Coconut oil makes a very rich lather, and it's very nourishing to your skin, which is very healthy for you. Instead of adding extra products after your bath or shower, lotions or whatever for your skin, if you use a good quality homemade bar of soap, you will not need to spend your money on those extra products that you apply later. Coconut oil is great for that. It's very, very nourishing with a big, nice lather. Okay, I'm putting 30 ounces of coconut oil. All right, we're almost there both ways. We're almost to 30 and we're almost to the tippity top. This is gonna be a close call. This pitcher isn't a very good pitcher for this. Oh, there we go. 30, perfect. Right there. Look what a nice, clear oil it is. It's very different from olive oil. This is clear looking and olive oil is like yellowy looking. So I love coconut oil. Now we're doing the lye and we need 5.44 ounces of lye. We're almost there, 5.4. The scale doesn't go to 5.44 ounces. I'm gonna take a little bit of lye out of here and I'm gonna explain why. When you're measuring your lye, if you have to make a mistake, an error, always error under the amount of lye you need. Let's just take a teeny weeny little bit out because of that reason, just to be on the safe side. And you wouldn't think that little teeny weeny bit would make a difference, but you know, just to be on the safe side and do everything properly and make sure that everything is the proper measurements. Now we're gonna measure out the water and we need 13.6 ounces of distilled water. The recipe has to be very precise if you want your bars to come out properly. I know I say that over and over again, but it's very, very important because you don't want to go through all this effort of getting all your stuff out and, you know, having all your ingredients and then your bars don't turn out. That's very disappointing. Okay, there we go, 13.6. So we're done measuring. We don't need the scale anymore. Alrighty, we're going to put the lye into the water. Always make sure you do it that way. You don't pour the water into the lye because it might splash. Don't forget your safety goggles and your mask because it's very stinky. It lets fumes up. So I'm just gonna do that right now. I'm gonna pour the lye into the water. And it's gonna get very, 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 very hot. Now we wait until it's 100 degrees before we add it to the oil. Alrighty, it's 100 degrees. So I'm gonna set this thermometer down and we're gonna add the lye and water mixture to the oil. I have my spoon here, so we just add it in slowly, and I'm just gonna slowly stir it. You know, you wanna be a little bit careful when you're doing this. You just don't wanna splash, you know. You don't have to be afraid of it. You just don't wanna splash. So just pour it in nice, nice and easy. I'm not gonna bring this to, you know, almost trace because I wanna add coloring, so I'm gonna leave it a little thin and then I'm gonna separate it into separate containers and add my coloring. So we're just gonna mix this up a bit. I And like I've said in my past soap making videos, you only do the electric mixer for 20 seconds. Then you stop and you stir it like this. Just have a look at it. Otherwise, what's going to happen is you're going to bring it to trace too fast and you're not going to be able to add your coloring or get it into the molds. And we're going to see how it looks. And I'm going to put the cedar wood in now. Today I'm using cedar wood. You dump in the whole 10 milliliter bottle to the recipe. Okay, now we're going to pulsate again for 20 seconds. Soap is a necessity. And you can make good, healthy, homemade soap. So that kind of, you know, check in that box. But also, if you want to have a little fun and you could add some creativity to it with your different molds, your different colors, and your different fragrances. So you're kind of, you know, killing two birds with one stone. You're covering the necessities, but you're also being able to be creative and let your creative juices flow, which makes it so much fun and so awesome. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to separate this into two different containers because I want to add the color before it comes to trace. All right, so we're going to divide this directly in half. So we're going to do 24 and 24 ounces. So try to be kind of careful. Got to go slow at the end here. Okay, there we go. This one's going to be blue. This one's going to be orange. So I have the orange here and I have the blue. Okay, 1 tablespoon of orange. We want it nice and bright. Okay, so I'm gonna bring this to trace now. All right, that's 20. So we're not there yet. It's gonna take a minute. Really coming to trace. Now you see how it leaves the little boop when I pull it up? That's trace. Now we're going to do a teaspoon of blue. Very bright, nice blue. There we go. Now we're going to start mixing. That came out. It's as blue as my dress almost. All right, getting there. That's tracing. Do you see the line? It has reached trace. So it's thick, like thin pudding. And you can see that. So it's time to put it in the mold. Okay, so we're doing 24 ounces of the orange and we're doing 24 ounces of the blue because we're gonna do a two-tone soap today. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna tap this because I want it to be on the bottom. Okay, so you want it like really on there and as flat as can be. I got a couple just little, very small little splotches on there. And just to make the soap extra perfect, I'm gonna wipe those off with a piece of tissue. Now you don't wanna go too deep or you're gonna be smudging even more on there. So, you know, you want it good, but it's hard to get it exactly perfect, perfect, perfect. But like that. Alrighty, now it's time to put the blue in there. So here we go. We're gonna go nice and slow. And easy, so we want it just to barely go on top. We don't want it to blob into the orange. We want it to be its own thing. What a nice color blue this turned out to be. Just a teaspoon did it too. And I like to take the time just to scrape every bit out I can. Now I am going to smooth it out a little because since it did reach trace, like I said, it's piled up right there in the middle where I was dumping it. So I'm going to go like this. And move it a little bit to the ends. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna cover this. We're gonna put the cardboard over it and we're gonna get our towels and we're gonna cover it so it can cure. You have to do this for 24 hours. You don't want it to cool down fast and that's the whole purpose. Okay, so then we're just gonna cover this up good. So I'm just gonna use 3 towels, that's enough. And then we're gonna leave it sit until tomorrow and then we're gonna open it up and get it out of the mold. See you then. Okay, it's been 24 hours. It's time to open the soap and cut it. Here we go. So we're gonna take all the towels off. See what it looks like under there. Ooh, I got a peek. Ooh, looks nice. Ooh, that's heavy with soap. Every time I make a batch of soap, I just love the soap. Every time I open it, it smells really good too. Ta-da! Ooh, that looks so nice. I want to turn it that way to cut it though. Just a nice big bar of soap. That's how, you know, I just wing it on the size I cut it. There we go. Isn't that nice? Nice shiny gator soap. That's what it is. Gator soap. We love our gators. Go Gators! And this soap is going to lather. It's going to have a really good lather to it. Also, this soap can be used as shampoo. Okay, so I'm going to cut it small ways this way to make little bars. You know, sometimes that can go on the sink in the bathroom or whatever. It is nice to cut different sizes, or sometimes somebody wants to try your homemade soap and you can just give them a small bar instead of giving them a great big bar. So that's why small bars and smaller sizes are very nice and very handy. Because I'm like soap greedy. I don't want to waste my big bars of soap on somebody who's like, oh, I just want to try it. I'm like, oh, it's precious. I don't want to waste it just in case they don't like it. If there were three bars of soap and this was one of them in the shower, you can bet your bottom dollar they're going to go for this bar of soap when they get in the shower. It's just so bright and cheery and fun, but it's very practical at the same time. So homemade soap is just wonderful. It's so much fun. It's just a great, great thing to get into. Okay, now we're gonna stack it in the box that has the needlepoint in it so it can cure for 4 to 6 weeks. That's the minimum. You know, you can use it after that, but the longer it cures, the better it gets. But I never can wait until it's fully cured. I always grab a bar and start using it. So, but it's fine, it's safe. Here we go, nice stacked up soap in the box. It feels smooth, it's very nice. Love my homemade soap. And I'm sure you will too. That's why I want everybody to try it. I just know you'll love it. And it's so easy, anybody can make it. That's the good part, you know, you don't have to be some special person to make homemade soap. Anybody can do it. If you want the top of the bar to look as dark blue and uniform as the side, you can scrape that off a little bit with a knife, or don't even worry about it if you're not too picky like me. And the first time you wash in the bath or the shower, that'll come off and it'll be dark blue like that. Here's the recap. You buy your different colored dyes first. Scott will put the links below. Then you get your coconut oil, your lye and water, mix it up, weigh it all out, mix it up, separate it into separate bowls, add the coloring, pour it in the molds, and voila, there you go. Sports team soap for the gator lovers in your life. It's really easy and fun. Making homemade soap is so easy and so much fun, and the end product is so fabulous. So go ahead and give it a shot. You will not be disappointed. What sports team soap do you want me to make next? Tell me in the comments below.
Sign up for Becky's Homestead newsletter. Go to beckyshomestead.com and sign up on the right. You'll get articles, news, and specials from Becky every month. Unsubscribe anytime, no spam. If you like this video, click the like button. It really does help us a lot. And if you want to be notified every time we post a new video, click the subscribe button.
If you would like to help support Becky's Homestead so we can make more videos for you, when you do your shopping, if you go through our link on Amazon, you don't pay one penny extra, but Amazon gives us a small percentage of every purchase. And that helps us to produce more nice homesteading videos for all of you out there. The link is at the top of my website.